Hey guys, it is Julie here with JT Wealth. In today's video, we are talking about three exciting IPOs coming up this week. So let's get into it. All right, welcome back guys. Thank you so much for being here. So this week is the biggest week for IPOs since Uber went public back in 2019. Now there are a handful of notable companies that are going public this week, and today's video we are going to focus in on three of those. Those three are going to be Snowflake, Amwell, and Unity. Before we get into those, this is just your friendly reminder to please make sure that you are subscribed to the channel, and if you like the video, give us a big thumbs up as well. Don't forget to check out some of our awesome links down below. They include a link to my Patreon group, also referral links that'll get you some free stocks or free money if you're looking to start a new investment account. And I have my awesome Globe Decanter through my Amazon links too. First up on our list today is Snowflake. Now you may remember hearing about these guys last week in our midweek stock market news update when we discussed their announcement of going public on Wednesday, September 16th. Now Snowflake is one of the buzziest IPOs ever, as they are expected to go public this week with a value around $30 billion. That would make Snowflake, who will be trading under the ticker Snow, the most valuable software startup ever to go public and the fifth most valuable tech startup ever. So there is a lot of excitement surrounding this IPO, and that is also partly due to some very big name investors. They have one of the most coveted investment partners in Berkshire Hathaway, which is Warren Buffett's company, who will be investing more than $500 million in this IPO. Now, this is despite Warren Buffett's typical aversion to young startup companies and IPOs. And Berkshire is not the only big name investing in these guys, as Salesforce has also committed $250 million. So Snowflake produces database software with a similar standard of Oracle, but it can be used in the cloud and scaled up and down as needed with variable pricing to match. Tech investment analyst Beth Kindegg said that they are bringing an Amazon-like approach to data warehousing. As more companies move to the cloud, Snowflake's technology, which separates stored data from the computing power needed to analyze it, is gaining momentum. Last year, the company's revenue jumped 174% to $265 million and was the fastest growing business application of 2019 by usage. All of the excitement surrounding this Snowflake IPO means that it is not going to be a cheap stock to get. So last week when they announced their IPO, we were looking at shares coming out between $75 to $85. But in a new filing to the SEC on Monday, Snowflake has raised that expected price by 30% and is now going to be coming out between $100 to $110 per share. Now, there are some people who thought even at the $75 to $85 range that this IPO was overpriced. This IPO analyst said that Snowflake is attractive from a fundamental standpoint, with industry-leading revenue growth numbers, a long growth runway ahead, improving margins, strong management, and a healthy balance sheet. However, many peers who have been around for 5 to 10 years longer have yet to turn a profit. So he believed that the asking price is too expensive considering the lack of visibility on the margin outlook and would pay $50 per share. So $50 a share is obviously a far cry from $100 to $110 per share, which is now the expected price. And on the other side of this, we have IPO Boutique. Now these guys are an IPO research and advisory firm, and according to them, the deal is many multiple times oversubscribed, meaning that requests for shares far exceed what is being offered. The shares could likely range from $120 to $125, and the valuation to traditional investors appears to be stretched. But given this company's excellent growth profile, strong and highly unique backers, and presence in the cloud data space, there is an exponential amount of demand for this IPO. They gave them a 5, which is the highest rating on their 1 to 5 scale for IPOs. So obviously we have a bit of a gap in opinions as far as the pricing of this stock, but we will just have to wait and see tomorrow what price this comes out at and how much it moves from there. Next on our list is a company called Amwell, who is one of the largest telehealth providers and builds technology for virtual doctor's visits. So Amwell will be going public on Wednesday, September 16th, and have set their price between $14 to $16 per share. Also investing in Amwell is Google's cloud division, who will be investing $100 million in a private placement at their IPO price. As part of this partnership, Amwell will be moving parts of its business from Amazon Web Services, which it currently uses, over to the Google Cloud, and will be specifically choosing Google Cloud as its preferred worldwide cloud partner. The two companies will also cooperate together on technology and building out a dedicated sales effort to expanding Amwell's footprint in the sector. Amwell competes with other telehealth companies such as Teladoc, who is a stock that we have talked about before, who's seen phenomenal growth lately, as now more than ever, people are avoiding in-person medical appointments at hospitals or clinics. So the demand and usage of these virtual doctor appointments has been skyrocketing in the last few months. Amwell works with 55 health plans that support over 36,000 employers and collectively represents more than 80 million covered lives, as well as 150 of the nation's largest health systems, encompassing more than 2,000 hospitals. To date, Amwell says it's covered over 5.6 million telehealth visits for clients, including more than 2.9 million just in the first half of 2020. Now, the company does have significant losses, but has seen a massive boost in revenue during this pandemic surge of telehealth demand. Visits in April 2020 were as high as over 40,000 per day versus approximately 2,900 visits per day in April of 2019. The company reported that average wait times during the surge still remained under 10 minutes. And Amwell raised $194 million back in May to help keep up with the skyrocketing demand for virtual care services. In the first half of 2020, their revenue has jumped 77% up to $122 million. So for a telehealth company, I think there is no better time to go public, as this demand for virtual doctor's appointments isn't going to subside anytime soon. Third on our list today is Unity Software, who is going public on Thursday, September 17th. Now, what makes their IPO interesting is how they are going about doing it, which I will circle back to after I give you a brief explanation of who they are. Unity is a software company specifically dealing in video game development platforms. The Unity Gaming Engine is a cross-platform gaming engine, meaning it can be utilized in both the PC and console applications. You'll probably recognize some of the games that Unity's tech has been a part of, such as Pokemon Go, Fortnite, and League of Legends. In 2017, Unity worked with Google Cloud for online game developers. And in June 2020, they announced a partnership with Apple to update the Unity engine to run on Apple Silicon-equipped Macs, allowing developers to update their games to support the new platform. So this company is by no means an unknown in the tech realm. But like I said, what makes this IPO so interesting is in the means in which they plan to conduct their big day. Unlike most IPOs who allow the underwriting banks to control the price action, Unity has seized control of this process. Unity's CEO, John Riccitiello, decided that his internal team would decide how the company's shares get priced and who gets the allocations. It is expected to be one of the hottest IPOs of this wave lately, as the company is coming from a really strong base and solid growth, as their revenue is up 39% from last year and their net losses have narrowed significantly. Riccitiello, who spent much of his career at Electronic Arts, most recently as CEO, and also co-founded private equity firm Elevation Partners, wanted a more transparent process that put him in control, said the People. Riccitiello has been working with David Ludwig, Goldman's head of America's equity capital markets, on the strategy. Unity's offering is closer to a typical IPO in that the new investors will get an allocation of shares at a certain price and the stock will start trading publicly the following day. However, the company is using a novel process of getting to the price and determining the allocation. Investors will submit their bids for a certain price and then the number of shares they want. Richitello's team will then choose a price based on where the bids land. Any investors who submitted an offer below the chosen price won't receive shares. For those that put in bids at or above the final price, Unity executives will decide on the allocation with the ability to fill investor requests in whole or in part. So it is basically a blind bid for Unity's IPO, and it'll be really interesting to see where those bids come in at and what share price we end up with. So those are three IPOs that I'm excited about this week. Now I know there's a good many others coming out as well that are exciting, but I didn't want this video to be half an hour, so just wanted to narrow in. But let me know your thoughts on these three and other IPOs that you're watching this week. So make sure that you leave a comment down below, make sure that you're subscribed to the page, and make sure that you give us a big thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching and have an awesome day. Cheers.